Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises and Todays. Video will be Book of Job, Chapter 31. Let's get started now. The Book of Job is a famous story from the Hebrew Bible that is often cited for its powerful teachings on faith, suffering, and the nature of God. Chapter 31 is the final chapter of Job's defense against the accusations of his friends, who argue that he must have committed some simple warrant the suffering he has endured. In this chapter, Job presents his final arguments and proclaims his innocence, expressing his faith in God's justice and calling for God to vindicate him. The chapter begins with Job making a solemn oath to God that he has not lusted after another woman or committed adultery. He acknowledges that such sins would have been a betrayal of his wife and a violation of God's law. He also asserts that he has not been dishonest in his dealings with others, cheating them or withholding what is due to them. He affirms that he has always treated his servants fairly and not taken advantage of their vulnerability or lack of power. Job goes on to deny that he has been guilty of covetousness, taking pleasure in material possessions or seeking to accumulate wealth at the expense of others. He insists that he has not worshipped idols or put his trust in anything other than God. He declares that he has been generous to the poor and the needy, sharing his resources with those who are less fortunate. He asserts that he has not rejoiced in the misfortunes of others or sought to aid them in any way. Job then turns to the question of his own mortality, acknowledging that death is inevitable and that he will one day stand before God in judgment. He expresses his fear of God and his belief that all people will be held accountable for their actions. He declares that he has not kept silent in the face of injustice or failed to speak out on behalf of the oppressed. He insists that he has not concealed his own sins or refused to acknowledge his faults, but has sought to be transparent and honest in all his dealings. Finally, Job calls upon God to hear his defense and to vindicate him against the accusations of his friends. He expresses his confidence that God will judge him fairly and acknowledges that he will accept whatever verdict God pronounces. He affirms his faith in God's justice and mercy, declaring that he will continue to trust in God even if he is not spared from suffering or granted relief from his afflictions. The teachings of Job 31 are many and varied, but some of the most important include the following. The importance of personal integrity. Job's defense has on his steadfast commitment to honesty, fairness, and ethical behavior in all his dealings with others. He emphasizes the importance of treating others with respect and compassion, and of avoiding the temptations of greed, lust, and materialism. He also acknowledges the importance of self-reflection and self-examination, recognizing the need to acknowledge one's faults and seek forgiveness when necessary. The inevitability of mortality. Job acknowledges that death is an inevitable part of the human experience, and that all people will one day stand before God in judgment. He emphasizes the importance of living one's life with integrity and purpose, recognizing that every action has consequences that will be evaluated in the final judgment. The power of faith, throughout his defense, Job expresses his faith in God's justice and mercy, even in the face of overwhelming suffering and adversity. He affirms his belief that God will ultimately vindicate him and bring about a just resolution to his troubles. His example reminds us of the importance of faith in times of trial, and the role that faith can play in sustaining us through even the most difficult circumstances. In conclusion, the Book of Job Chapter 31 is a powerful message that emphasizes the importance of living a righteous life and being accountable for one's actions. Job's final defense proclaims his innocence and integrity, igniting his commitment to living a life of righteousness and avoiding immoral behavior. Obrigado por nos visitar hoje. Por favor, compartilhe conosco seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer, ansioso para vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!